Hello guys, what's up? I'm Taufiqur Rahman. Welcome to my programming channel. And you see, this is one of my products on code cleaning tips and tricks. I hope that you have already purchased it. And today I'm going to make app customization videos based on this product. This is our technical documentation link. I have already opened it. And let's go to the app customization section. And today I'm going to show you how can you change the contents and image URLs. So here are the guidelines to change contents. Open contents.json file as shown in the screenshot. Our app support session formatted text. To make formatted text, you need to go to this site. So let's open it. And you see, this is our online HTML editor. Let's make it maximize. Then go to source, mark all the text. Click backspace and then again click source and write your text here, like this is an example text, this is a new line, this is a paragraph, blah blah blah. So here you can make a text bold, mark it and click bold, and then you can make it italic. Actually you have a lot of options here, but you cannot use all of them because Android Studio supports a few formatted text. So I'm showing you all like bold, italic, and that's it. And you can make formatted text like text inside inverted commas, in or quotation mark, s, etc. So this is the new line, this is the paragraph, and this is our text. And you see, this is the generated source code. Again click source and here you can change your contents. Let's open the document again and you see here are the precaution list. Go to the link of the online HTML editor we provide and insert image as shown in the below screenshot. So now we are going to discuss about how to insert images on the description section. So here, to change the contents, open contents.json file. So let's open the contents.json file. And you see, this is our contents.json file. It contains title, image URL, and details. Let's create a new content. Like, I'm going to copy it because I'm lazy, comma, and then paste it. And let's, what can be our title? Like test title. Now the most important thing is the image URL. You see, at the bottom of the section about changing app contents and images, here is a paragraph. We don't want to make the size of our app too large. That's why we paste images from online and used image cache for offline reading. Okay, if you have a website, then you can upload your images there and get the direct image URL. If you don't have a website or you don't want to upload your images in a server, then you can upload images in Google Drive and get the direct image link. Okay, so to get the direct image URL from Google Drive, you need to check out this video. And you see, this is an image. Actually, this is a direct image URL. And you see, we have uploaded our image in the Google Drive and we took the direct image link. Let's copy it and paste it in our browser. Let's see what happens. You see, this is not just a Google Drive file. It's the direct image link. So you need to take the direct image URL at first, and then you have to paste it here. And here comes the details section. So we are going to put our details here, and we have already wrote something as our detail text, and we are going to insert an image here. So to insert image, you need to go to the below screenshot. So you see here is the way to insert image. So go to the online HTML editor, click here, and you need to paste your URL. Like this is our URL. Control C, Control V, alternative text, like what can we write, like clock, and make width 100% and height like 250 is good. Click OK. And you see this is the image preview, and in Android it will look good, but in desktop it is stressed, don't worry. Then again go to source, here is the generated source code, and then mark all, Control C, open a new tab, Control V, paste it, again mark all, and then copy it, and you need to paste it in the details section. And you see here is a red warning. So let's open our documentation. Let's read it. After inserting data with image, you will see red warnings or error message in the contents.json file. To remove those warnings, insert a backslash before every quotation mark in the image insertion code. Okay, this is our contents.json file. Here is the image insertion code, image alter, and you need to insert a backslash, again backslash, up before every quotation mark. So no quotation mark, here is one, this is another one, and you see the red warnings are gone. So we are good to go. Then an implementation, you can found an implementation. These are the points for example implementations. So this is our new contents, and its title is test title. We have inserted image URL, and we have inserted details which contains images. So that's it. So at first you need to open contents.json file. Okay, we have opened it, and then we have opened the online HTML editor. Go to source, and you see this is our descriptions. We can take the title also from here, then go to source, mark all, copy, paste, mark all, copy, and then you can paste it in the details. Okay, so that's it. Thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe.